Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to 1Export's Lunch and Learn. As we find and hack our way to our product market fit, we now realize that we need to do some automated testing at our current stage. And so today, we have one of the women who code Manila's evangelist, Mary Grace Maliari, to talk about the meeting software testing. Thank you, Mary Grace.
Thank you, Reza, for that wonderful introduction. Can you hear me clearly? Okay. So I'll present my screen. Yeah. Can you see my screen now?
Yes.
Okay. So good day, everyone. Hope you are having a good day. And first of all, thanks for this chance to share with you what I learned about software testing. And it is really an honor for me to be part of the Lunch and Learn series. And yeah, let's all meet software testing. So I would like to add more on my introduction. So I started my career as a manual tester for 4 years, and I'm currently working in home credit. Shifted as a automation tester for more than a year now. And I also work part-time as lead QA engineer in Atmos Cloud Solutions. So it's a startup company, and also focusing on the growth and continuous improvement, which I also have the Lean Six Sigma yellow belt. But we're baby pa lang tayo dun, so marami pang level si Lean Six Sigma. And yeah, it is my newfound interest to do public speaking. It's my way of helping to the community and companies to share what I learned. So my other interests are hosting and organizing tech events like hackathon, conferences, and meetups. And also, during my free time, I do random videos for my YouTube channel. So yung mga recent ko na ina-upload is about life journey. So nice to meet you, everyone. And let's not be super formal here. Feel free to interrupt me anytime for questions or clarifications. Okay, so software field is growing very rapidly in the last decade. So the users have become more demanding and faster applications are being asked. So while businesses invest a lot of time and money on developing such software, sometimes they refuse to invest on its testing. So this can have minor to major consequence. So for our agenda for today, so we will answer why software should be tested. And we will check the relative cost of fixing a bug. And let's have the testing principles and manifesto. And lastly, let's have an analogy about delivering software using this chocolate wrapping. So software testing is really essential. It's a type of inspection wherein an application under test is analyzed from every dimension to ensure delivery of a quality product. So as a rule or standard, a software product should only be released after it has gone through a proper process of development, testing, and bug fixing. So testing looks at areas such as performance, stability, and error handling by setting up test scenarios under controlled conditions and assessing the results. So have you seen software bugs posted in social media, or have you experienced one na gumamit kayo ng web app or mobile app where you encountered problems or bugs like it keeps crashing or super tagal mag-load? So example here is meron ginawang pang smoke test yung production environment, and then nalimutan ata nila i-clear yung test data. So let's not mention name of the applications or products here, but yeah, I think it's a bit obvious kung ano siya. But yeah, I want to give another example. So one of our friends shared her experience on paying internet bill in advance, but still they got disconnected because they did not pay 2 consecutive months, which is the ISP's rule. So the company forgot to check that the customer has zero amount due. So if you can check on the screen. And then what do they need to pay? So one theory we got in this situation is that the tech end billing team is not integrated, so nobody knows what's wrong with their system. But it's just, in our opinion, it's both the system and process are not correct. So we got the lesson here is, first is requirements analysis is really important to check for loopholes, set scope and limitations of the system, and analyze integration with other systems from different departments. Second is thinking of possible scenarios on the application that we are creating will have a great impact for our high quality software. And of course, preventing to receive negative customer feedback. Lastly is, as a QA or tester, we have to make sure that the system is working as it should be. There's no perfect system, but we can at least assure that the system's features are mistake-proof. So this is why exactly any software has to be tested. But I'm not saying those examples I gave didn't undergo testing, but ayun, since na-encounter na yung issues sa production environment, we need to take extra effort on the quality of the product. So it is important to note that software is mainly tested to see that it meets the customer's needs and that it conforms to the standard. So it is a usual norm that software is considered of good quality. Ayun. So do you have questions on this part before I move on? None. Okay. So since we introduced or discovered some bugs already, let's tackle the relative cost of fixing it. So it simply costs are logarithmic and they increase in size tenfold as the time increases. So as you can see, a bug found and fixed during the early stages, which is the requirements analysis or products specification, can be fixed by a brief interaction and might cost next to nothing. So during coding naman, a sweeply spotted mistake may take only very less effort to fix it. So developer can already check on that. While during testing, it's already, it has cost of the paperwork of a bug report and a formally documented fix, as well as the delay and expense of a retest. So nagkakaroon na tayo ng turnaround time for that. And finally, during operations, it may cause anything from an inconvenience to a system failure. Possibly, merong mga consequences na especially yung mga critical systems such as aircraft, emergency services, or applications na bank or anything involves money. So in short, bugs found later cause more to fix. So there are different ways to perform the software testing, but a software tester should choose the exact strategy and method so that we can achieve optimum test results. So a well-crafted strategy involves a set of principles and practices. So we have the first one is, first principle is, testing shows the presence of defects. So every testing team confirms that the software meets all business requirements and it is functioning as per the needs of the end user. So in the software testing industry, no one will say that there is no defect in the software, which is quite true. So as testing cannot prove that the software is error-free or defect-free. So example in this, yung mga commercials ng alcohol, mga hand soap, so they'll say that this can kill 99.9% of germs or 99%. So clearly proves that the product is not 100% germ-free. So same as our testing concept, we can say that no software is defect-free, yung totally 100%. Next principle is exhaustive testing is not possible. So it is not possible to test all the functionalities with all the valid and invalid combinations, lalo na kung malaki yung scope ng example yung field. So instead of this approach, testing of a few combinations is considered based on priority and gumagamit tayo ng mga different techniques. And also, we need to consider yung project timelines. Kaya we have these techniques like example is equivalence partitioning and boundary value analysis. So in this screen, ang allowed lang daw ni age is 18 to 56. So we partition those valid values, 18 to 56, and then partition below 18 as an invalid and above 56 as an invalid value also. So we partition it. And then we get value from that partition and we'll try to input or use that as a data. So that's one of the techniques we can use. And then third one is early testing. So here, early testing means that all of the testing activities should start in the early stages of the software development life cycle. So I remember dito during the Lunch and Learn series then, there's a software development life cycle. So tester is not asleep. This is not sleeping and just nagigising lang kapag testing part na. So we do early testing pa lang sa requirements analysis. And to perform that, we will need the requirement specification documents. And if the requirements are defined incorrectly, then it can be fixed directly rather than fixing pa dun sa development stage or another stage pa ng SDLC. So, baka matanong nyo or question is, how early should the testing start? So, once the requirements are finalized and the testers need to be involved in the testing na. And yeah, any type of document, requirements documents, specification document, anything that you can have. We usually have this acceptance criteria. We can rely on that for the testing. So fourth principle is the defect clustering. So it means a small number of modules containing most of the defects. Basically, the defects are not distributed uniformly across the entire applications. Defects are concentrated or centralized across two or three functionalities lang. So at times, possible dahil sa complexity ng feature or ng specific application, kaya yung coding may be complex or tricky. So a developer may make a mistake or which might impact on just a specific functionality or module only. So that's what we check on the defect clustering. And then fifth one is the pesticide paradox. So this principle defined that if we are executing yung test cases, so as QA, we prepare test cases to be executed. And if we do that again and again, magpapas lang siya since possibly na-resolve na yung mga issues before or talagang stable na yung feature na yon or yung type of scenario. Ayun, during mga first few years ko sa software testing, na feel ko nga na, ha, paulit-ulit lang yung ginagawa ko kasi ito na yung steps eh. So, ina-execute ko na lang and then lagi naman siyang nagpapas. So, ang principle here is it is necessary to revise and update yung nagawa mong test cases before. And it is also a good idea to add new test cases so that new and more defects can be found in different areas of software. So second to the last is testing is context dependent. So there are several domains available in the market like banking, medical, etc. So and each domain has a number of applications and their applications are have different requirements, functions, and different techniques and purpose. So different domains are tested differently Thus, testing is purely based on the context of the domain or the application. So, example, nagtetest ka ng banking application. It's different when you move or you test to an e-commerce website or an advertising application. So, you need to shift your mindset also on that. And the risk associated with each type of application is really different. Thus, it is not effective to use the same method or mga techniques na pwede mong i-apply dun, halimbawa sa banking and to other application. So, lastly is the absence of errors fallacy. So, finding and fixing defects does not help if your system does not fulfill the user's expectations and needs. So, kailangan din natin ma-make sure na nami-meet niya yung ano talaga yung kailangan ng user mo or ng audience or kung sino yung gagamit ng system. So, once the application is completely tested and there are no bugs identified before the release, we can say that the application is 99% bug-free, but there is a chance na yung application tested is naka-base sa incorrect requirements or hindi siya nag-a-align dun sa user's needs. So, identify the flaws and fix them on a given period will not help as testing is done on the wrong specification. Kumbaga, natapos mo na lahat yung process mo pero iba pala yung dapat na kailangan gawin ng system. So, kaya importante sa part na to yung never assume sa requirements. So, laging i-verify or confirm na, yung mga nasa documents. So, para aligned yung testing natin sa user's needs. So, naalala ko lang din, lagi kong bugat sa mga business analyst or PO before ang first statement ko. Ma'am or sir, clarify ko lang po itong requirement or flow. Ayun. Tapos, siguro nakukulitan na rin sila sa akin na laging ganun yung bungad ko na paano po ba tong requirement na to? So, ano po yung flow? Yun yung mga parang ano ko, parang lines ko na kapag nagtatanong sa kanila. So, ganun, that's how it is. And if hindi clear, kailangan natin i-verify yun kasi tayo din yung mag-struggle in the end. And always remember the cost of bug fixing. So, that's the testing principle.
So, question po.
Mm-hmm.
Sa DB clustering, meron po bang ano? Kasi ang naisip ko na sa DB clustering is, ano, for example, 500 or 400 error. Meron po bang ano, mas specific na categorization para sa defect?
Usually you'll count the overall defect per scenario. Per specific feature and then parang yun yung i-cluster mo na eto mas mataas yung defect na na-encounter ko sa specific feature na to. So, that's how we cluster. Pero yung mga, yung percentage, we do the percentage kung ano yung feature na mas merong maraming defects.
So, basically po, pag defect clustering, parang may feature na release, then chine-check nyo lang yung mga defects na nakuha mula dun sa feature na yun from the testing. Tas listing lang din.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's more of a metrics.
Thank you po.
Welcome. So, let's move on. I think most of us are familiar with the Agile Manifesto. And if not, you can search on that later because we're doing the testing manifesto, which is also an analogy to that Agile manifesto. So it's this testing manifesto was created by Karen Greaves and Samantha, and it reflects the mindset shift needed for a successful Agile testing approach. So anytime your team is stuck on a quality or testing problem, just reflect on this manifesto and to find a way to move ahead. So let's have a look on each value. First is testing throughout over testing at the end. So to achieve this, treat testing as an ongoing activity rather than just a phase. And second is preventing bugs over finding bugs. So malaki yung difference niya. And testing involvement at the beginning essentially helps you prevent defects and save considerable amount of time. Third value is testing understanding over checking functionality. So ensuring the client requirements are well understood and met in the design before the development begins. Fourth is building the system, the best system over breaking the system. So with continuous feedback and collaboration, and the intent for all teams is to ship the best quality release. And finally, team responsibility for quality over tester responsibility. So considering quality no matter what our role is. So yun yung lagi ko hina-highlight na hindi lang as a tester sila yung parang in charge dun sa kapag may issues, may bugs sa system. Yeah. So importante talaga yung testing manifesto. You have question po? Okay. So we're almost done. So familiar ba kayo sa sitcom na I Love Lucy? Nakuha ko lang din siya from other meeting and I tried to have an analogy on this. So let's all watch this. And later I'll explain to you yung software delivery analogy. Ayan, test ko lang muna yung ayan, naririnig nyo? Oh. No sounds?
Mahina.
Ah, mahina. Wait lang. Try uli natin. Meron na?
Wala pa din po eh.
Wala pa rin. Aww. So, translate ko na lang. Translate. Okay. So, in this scenario, meron silang parang nasa chocolate factory sila and ang goal nila is to wrap the chocolates and yung ito is the manager. Then sabi niya, yeah, last chance. Kapag may lumagpas na chocolate na unwrap dun sa belt is fired na sila. So, medyo challenging. So, nagwo-work daw sila fine, so lalong pinabilis. So, yun yung parang nakita ko na nakakatawa siya, pero pagka inanalyze mo is, bakit ganun? Bakit parang total chaos na yung nangyari sa kanila? So, let's have that analogy. Gamitin natin sila. So, the two chocolate eaters are the software development team, while the lady in the middle is the management. So the chocolates in the conveyor belt are the items on the application. As what we saw, some are not nicely wrapped, and it's not in high quality. And they ate some of it, place it on their working hats, and those items are not being delivered to the production. So which is not good or not ideal, and really it will cause chaos. Imagine the number of the chocolates expected to be wrapped versus the actual wrapped chocolates are not aligned. So same with us delivering an application. The client has a list of his or her needs, and she found out later on that it is not implemented on the system or the application. So what these three people should acquire? First is an excellent communication. So being able to communicate with both technical and non-technical people, it really effectively communicate, or we should discuss it with the issues we might encounter. We should discuss it with the development team or with the manager. So in the clip, baka pwede nilang sabihin na yung speed po medyo mabilis. So baka pwede po bagalan muna sa umpisa until ma-master namin or maging familiar kami sa process. So for the manager's view naman, he or she can closely monitor what the team are actually doing. Kasi yung nakita natin sa clip, parang bumabalik lang siya to see the actual output. So walang collaboration or coordination, kung pwede naman siya mag-ask ng question, okay ba yung naging process or may na-encounter ba kayong issues or problem during the execution, ganun, mga ganun. So second is integrity and transparency. So in whatever we do, there are some of the this integrity and transparency are some of the keys towards our successful goals or plans. So instead of hiding and eating the chocolates, they should say to their manager na, "Ma'am, di po namin kaya yung speed." So yes, takot sila mawalan ng work if di nila ma-deliver yung task. Pero mas malaking problem yung na-create because they did not have the chance to be honest on what is really happening. Lastly is to have the analytical thinking. So being able to analyze, tackle, and sort ideas to generate solutions, to have a problem-solving mindset. So nung umaandar na yung conveyor, they didn't even talk about or plan what they will do. Nag-execute or nag-work lang agad sila. So it's really important to have requirements analysis like like what I said earlier. So requirements analysis, design, and test planning before jumping to the execution. So a software tester will have these individualistic qualities and will vary from person to person. Each tester has a unique perspective which helps them to identify critical problems quickly. And this is a characteristic that is developed over time with practice and experience. So we need to continuously learn and provide real value to our customers, no matter if you use innovative testing tools or new practices. And yet, at the end of the day, as a modern tester or any other role from software development team, we should ask the following: how can I help to release faster and improve quality culture in my current company? So thank you, everyone. And I'm opening the floor for other questions. And here's my QR code for the GCash account. Just kidding. So there's the link on the email, LinkedIn, yeah, and YouTube.
So make sure ko po ipa-follow ko kayo after after this call. So natuwa ako doon sa Chocolate Robbie. Actually, hindi ko siya naisip nung pinanood ko siya. Akala ko comedy lang. Pero oo nga, funny but sad. So yung question ko po, if ever ba na yung katulad ng mga lighthouse, kasi kami familiar, ako personally familiar pala ako sa lighthouse, mapalizer para sa testing ng website. Baka po may iba pa kayong maibigay na web application or kaya web tools na pwede namin magamit for testing?
For testing, for web application, lagi lang talaga ako nagre-rely sa Chrome Dev Tools. So, especially for the checking ng maximum field number. Kasi important din siya for parang lagi kong chine-check yung front end and back end kung matched yung character limits to avoid yung error. And that's pretty much of it. And yung meron tayong mga list of techniques pa and strategies for the testing. So maybe I'll message or email it to Karen later on. So for the web, that's it. Chrome DevTools lang talaga yung ginagamit ko.
Okay. Noted ba po dito? May iba pa po bang questions? Okay. So mukhang wala na. Bettina, pwede yung pa-share na certificate? One Expert is awarding the Certificate of Appreciation for Ms. Mary Grace Maliari for sharing her knowledge for meat supper testing during the One Expert Lunch and Learn that took place this February 19, 2021. This is signed by Mel Naba, our CEO at One Expert, and Ms. Karen Matala, which is our CTO at One Expert. So thank you, Ms. Mary Grace, for that insightful session, and thank you for joining us, everyone. Next Thursday at 1 p.m., join us again for another Lunch and Learn session with Natalie Sia of TikTok, sharing with us her knowledge of product experimentation. See you then.
Thank you. Bye.
Thank you.
Thank you.